Hello students, today we are here, I am here to tell you about the geography, that is chapter number 2, but let's just have a review of the first chapter, the previous chapter, in which I have told you about the size and location of the country and also the position of the country in the whole world. Now here in the second chapter, this chapter number 2, the physical features of India. We have seen in that chapter about the location, but we should also know that in our country, all the major physical features of the earth, they are there. Like mountains are there, deserts are there, then plateaus are there, and plains are there. And you must be wondering to know how all these physical features they have been formed. We also know, you find it also the different types of rocks they are there in the country, and some they are very hard rocks like marble, which has been used in the ancient years by the kings and all. They used to use that in the making of Taj Mahal. Whereas some are very soft. They are just like the soap stove, which is used to make the talcum powder, which we are using in our daily life. The color of the soil also varies from one place to another. Somewhere we have seen that the black soil is there, somewhere red soil is there. So that also varies. Why? Because of different types of rocks and varieties. Now, different types of rocks, they are also formed due to the weathering process, and we have never thought, have you ever thought of about the causes of these variations, why these variations are there on the earth? These variations are caused due to different rock formation. Now let's see, India, it is a large landmass. It is formed during different geographical periods, which has influenced our relief. Besides the geographical formations, number of processes like weathering, I have told you about that, the breaking up of the rocks into very, very small particles and then changing it into soil, erosion, deposition, it has been created, it has been modified the relief of its present form. Now, earth scientists, they have also explained how the formation of physical features with the help of some of the theories they are based on that, and certain evidences they are also given. One such plausible theory, that is the theory of plate tectonics. Now this plate tectonics, actually the plates, they are found inside the earth and they keep on moving accordingly. Now, according to their movement, the topography of the earth, that is also formed. The movement is very, very slow, and so the things on the top, they keep on changing. Let's see the theory of according to this theory, the crust, that is the upper part of the earth, that is the crust, it has been formed out of 7 major and some minor plates. You will see in figure 2.1 here, the movement of these plates, they result in the building up of stress within the plates and the continental rocks above, leading to folding, faulting and volcanic activity. Whatever the activities they are there, it may be of volcanic activity, maybe earthquakes, they are there, folding, faulting. The gaps they have been formed, all these are due to those movement of the plates. While some plates, they come towards each other and they form convergent boundaries. Some plates, they move far away from each other and they form divergent boundaries. Now see, the movements, it's given, it's shown clearly in this, in these diagrams. You see, the convergent boundary, when the plates, they come divergent boundary is formed, and the transform boundary when they move away from alternate ways to from each other. So in this way, the boundaries they are formed. So we have seen in the event of two plates coming together, they may either collide and crumble also, or one may slide under the other also. Slide under other. They'll come close up, slide one on the other, and at times they may also move horizontally also. So this is what how these formations they took place each other, and they form transform boundary. As I have told you, the three types, the movement of these plates have changed the position and size of continents over million of years. This particular activity went on, and because of that, the changes they are there. Such movements have been influenced the evolution of present landform features. Whatever we see today, present, they are actually the activity which was taking place in the past old years, many, many years before. Now, the oldest landmass, the peninsula part, we have seen in the size and location, the peninsula part of India, it was a part of Gondwana land. It was one whole land, the whole world, one particular land was there, then it got split up into different parts and different countries they are set up afterwards. The Gondwana land included India was there in that, Australia, South Africa, and South America, and then Antarctica. It was actually one particular single land. But what happened? The conventional currents, it got split, the crust, into number of pieces, and thus leading to the Indo-Australian plate after being separated from the Gondwana land. That name was given to that towards the north. The northward drift resulted in the collision of the plate within such large elevation plate. Due to this collision, the sedimentary rocks which were accumulated in the geosyncline, they are known as the Pythias, they were folded to form the mountain system of Western Asia and Himalayas. So how this is how they are formed due to the split of the land. Now let's see, apart from that, let's come here, the definition of the Gondwana land is given here in the note. It is the southern part of the ancient supercontinent Pangaea and Angara lands in the northern part. Now, the Himalayan drift out of the DC and subsidence of the northern flank of peninsular plateau, it resulted in the formation of large basin. It was formed, and in due course of time, this particular depression gradually got filled with deposition of sedimentary by the rivers flowing from mountains in the north. We have seen the northern portion, the rivers, more and more rivers they flow in the northern side, and all those rivers, they are perennial. That means they have water throughout the year. They are perennial rivers, they are called. Now, a flat land of extensive alluvial deposits led to formation of northern plains of India. So when alluvial deposits they are there, the rivers they are flowing, the coast they are very, very fertile, the sea river shores they are fertile, and because of that the fertility is there, and in the northern plains it is very, very fertile. People means agriculture more and more it is practiced in the northern plains. Now the land of India, it also displays, the land of India, it displays great physical variations. The peninsular plateau constitutes one of the ancient landmarks on the earth's surface. It was an ancient one, and it was supposed to be one of the most stable land blocks. The Himalayas, the northern plains, they are most recent landforms now you can see. So from the viewpoint of geology, Himalayan mountains form an unstable zone. The whole mountain system of Himalaya represents a very beautiful topography with high peak are formed of alluvial deposits. Now, the peninsula plateau is composed of igneous and metamorphic rocks. They are found in the peninsula plateau. So we have seen the peninsula plateau, the three sides bounded by water. In the previous chapter, we have read. Now, after this, the next heading will be the next heading, the major physiographic divisions. I will tell you in our next lecture. Thank you.